even with the Me Too stuff, it's not as prevalent as it was. Do you know what I mean? Or do you just think that people, you know, they got everybody who they were going to get?
No, I think it's still prevalent. But I think what happens is there's so many times where like something will happen and then all of a sudden an explanation will come up or a person will just go away. So it's like anything else. There's so much of it. People are all just kind of looking in different directions. Oh, look at that one. Look at that one. Look at that one. It just seems like it's not the central story anymore. But for the last year, COVID has been the central story. Like, you know, whatever the central story is, you know, but they, I mean, again, after Harvey Weinstein, Bill Cosby, guys who are on that level.
Yeah, yeah.
Hard to find guys on that level of famous or that level of powerful, you know. But I think that for that to have the main stage again, it would have to be somebody who's on that level. And it's not that easy to find.
Yeah, yeah. Go ahead.
Being somebody in the public eye, does that ever affect how you date or relationships and stuff? Like,
Jim's honest though. He's an honest dude.
Right. Right. But I mean, is that even in the back of your head even ever?
No, honestly, it's not. I've always been paranoid. I've been paranoid for over 20 years. So I've always been really careful. And again, I don't drink. So I think a lot of guys when they're drunk do really things that they don't remember. Yeah. Yeah. Half the times they don't remember. But no, not really. I mean, I'm always surprised when somebody is attracted to me. I mean, it doesn't matter why. I'm always like, oh, good. That's great news. So no, it doesn't. I've never run around and went, she's going to want to fuck me. She's going to want to fuck me. I'm always like, yeah, all right. Thank you.
You're at least grateful. I mean, that's kind of nice. Yeah, you're like, sure. Every time someone fucks you, you give them a nice thank you note out of gratitude.
And a tip. Of course, and a tip. It's not for free.
But what's it been like dating wise lately, Jim? How is everything going for you?
It's okay. I mean, it's hard in this time.
Yeah.
For I think everybody and dating apps, I failed miserably on. I've tried them. I just, there was nothing there. I mean, it was one. I think the last real hurrah on a dating app was when I got stood up in LA. I was going to a friend of mine had this big party and there was going to be like some really cool people there. And this girl was in the business and she totally stood me up. And I was like, I just can't rely on dating app. I just can't do it. You know? So yeah, it's been kind of miserable like it is for most people.
Yeah, I mean, it's funny because even though there's a paranoia, but when you say there's a paranoia, you're like paranoid about, like, you're always looking over your shoulder anyway, when it comes to everything, not just the women thing, the whole,
everything since day one, everything. I've always wanted to check motives and be careful of what somebody is saying to me. And can I believe this? All way too much. I probably saved myself a lot of trouble doing that. And I probably also cost myself a lot of good experiences.
Yeah. Like, why do you think, where does that come from?
I don't know. I honestly don't know. I don't really have a good answer for you. I don't know.
Did you grow up with both parents?
I did. Yeah. Both my parents are still alive. Yeah. They're still married 53 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
And just like, are they outgoing or are they, you know, what's your dad like?
They're nice people. My dad is he's got a lot of friends, a good guy, retired, postal worker. He was in the military. Really, he's a really nice man. And my mother, yeah, they do like hospice work. They're just nice people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's always fascinates me that kind of disconnect between, you know, what you accomplish and what you think you're worth. You know what I mean? I think it's because I had a thing the other day where I was doing some gig on a roof and this is a younger comic and she just, you know, she had cut her hair and it was like curly. And I go, wow, your hair looks really nice. But it wasn't, I'm trying to fuck you. It wasn't an older comic who shall remain nameless, he just goes on this crazy diatribe about I don't even subscribe to that kind of complimenting a woman and demeaning her sexuality, and he just goes on and on and on and on. But what's interesting is like he's being sarcastic, like he's doing this whole over the top, and because there was an honesty into the compliment that I was given in the first place, she didn't take it creepy. She just, in fact, she was like, oh yeah, I cut it and it's shorter now. I kind of like it. You like it? It's not, you know, just, it was just really kind of honest. But I think what ha- happens is when people are not, authentic and genuine about their compliment, or when there's something else behind it, they're worried about how it's going to be, taken, because there's almost like they mean something behind it. Do you know what I mean? It was just an honest kind of compliment from me.
Young Man School 202. Better hear what I've got to say, because you won't get it again.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man.
Better man.
Put your happiness first, because if you don't, they won't.